Bine v-am găsit, dragi telespectatori, vă spunem la o nouă ediție Realități și Perspective. Astăzi discutăm despre Ierusalim, capitala Israelului, și ne propunem să avem ca invitat în câteva minute, prin Skype, direct din Ierusalim, pe Jürgen Bühler, președintele Organizației International Christian Embassy for Jerusalem, una dintre cele mai importante organizații pro-Israel din întreaga lume, care lucrează și slujește acolo în Ierusalim. Până atunci însă vreau să vă provoc să vă gândiți și să analizați un eveniment, cred eu, care a făcut în conjurul lumii, considerat de mulți evenimentul anului 2017, momentul în care președintele Trump al Statelor Unite al Americii a declarat și a recunoscut Ierusalimul ca și capitală a Israelului. O scurtă reamintirea acestui eveniment printr-o știre difuzată de noi, studio Alpha Omega TV, în emisiunile noastre anterioare.
This week marks one of the most momentous in the history of Jerusalem. For the first time, a U.S. president recognized Jerusalem as the capital of the Jewish state. Israeli leaders applauded the announcement. Evangelical leaders called it historic and prophetic, while many Muslim and Arab leaders condemned Trump's decision. We begin our look at this week with a report by CBN White House correspondent Jennifer Wishon.
By recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel and moving the U.S. embassy there, President Donald Trump has secured his place in history and demonstrated another reason why Americans elected an outsider, not beholden to tradition.
We cannot solve our problems by making the same failed assumptions and repeating the same failed strategies of the past.
After decades of failed peace negotiations and a continuation of violence, President Trump says it's time to do something different.
It is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.
For decades, Democrats and Republicans running for president dangled the promise of recognizing Jerusalem, only to fail to follow through once in office. President Trump delivered. He says he's just acknowledging reality, that Jerusalem has been Israel's capital for decades, and kicking off a new strategy for peace while reaffirming that the U.S. would support a two-state solution if that's what both sides agreed to.
Above all, our greatest hope is for peace, the universal yearning in every human soul.
Immediately, enthusiastic praise poured in from a diverse group of evangelical leaders. Former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee says President Donald Trump did what his predecessors didn't have the courage to do. In doing so, he set two great examples: how to make good on promises and how to treat your friends. Reverend Samuel Rodriguez says the historical record, empirical fact, and our faith all confirm that Jerusalem is in fact the capital of the Jewish people. I therefore enthusiastically applaud President Trump's decision. And Bishop Harry Jackson says it marks the beginning of a new season in U.S. Middle East policy. The previous administration allowed persecution, terrorism, and stereotyping of the Israeli people. President Trump called for a continuation of the status quo at Jerusalem's holy sites.
Jerusalem is today and must remain a place where Jews pray at the Western Wall, where Christians walk the stations of the cross, and where Muslims worship at Al-Aqsa Mosque.
With the president's announcement, now architects, engineers, and planners will begin building America's new embassy in Jerusalem. It will take some time to complete, but the president says he's building a magnificent tribute to peace. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, the White House.
A fost o știre care a provocat structurile poliției din întreaga lume, toate națiunile, toate bisericile din întreaga lume, o decizie de a spune, de a recunoaște în fond acest lucru, Ierusalim, capitala Israelului, și de a declara că procesul de mutare a ambasadei Statelor Unite de la Tel Aviv la Ierusalim poate să înceapă, o decizie amânată decenii de rândul de mai mulți președinți americani. Aparent, o decizie politică care ar trebui să ne afecteze mai puțin. Iată însă că această declarare, această recunoaștere a creat reacții în întreaga lume, reacții atât în sfera politică, mai ales în sfera politică, dar credem noi și în sfera spirituală, pentru că tot mai multe biserici, tot mai mult creștini au început să vorbească, să spună, să analizeze, să vadă care este semnificația spirituală acestei declarații. Desigur că acest aspect ne preocupă și pe noi, e emisiune care se numește Ia însăși realități și perspective, această perspectivă spirituală a acestei declarații, a începutului acestui proces și pentru a vă da câteva elemente, selectăm dintr-o știre recentă pe care am difuzat-o tot pe canalul Alfa Omega TV, produsă de colegii de la CBN, un fragment în care în studioul CBN-ului din America se discută puțin despre semnificația spirituală a acestei declarații, semnificație care va fi un punct de plecare pentru emisiunea noastră de astăzi.
Recunoașterea Ierusalimului va determina și alte națiuni să procedeze la fel. America conduce lumea. Chiar acum, ambasadorii lumii se află aici. Țările lumii îl vor urma pe președintele Trump. Îi veți vedea venind la Ierusalim. Ierusalimul nu este doar capitala Israelului, ci, conform Bibliei, în cele din urmă va fi capitala lumii. It's ultimately going to
be the capital of the world. Mai devreme, producătorul CBN Emily Jones a vorbit cu doctorul Courtney Backer de la Universitatea Regent și cu liderul de rugăciune de la CBN, Jay Comiskey, despre importanța spirituală a Ierusalimului.
Dr. Backer, are acest eveniment un caracter profetic?
This is an extraordinary event.
E un eveniment extraordinar. Chiar la începutul Noului Testament este evident că Ierusalimul va juca un rol important în istoria Israelului și, prin extensie, în istoria creștinismului. Adesea oamenii se întorc la David. Biblia spune de la început că Ierusalimul va fi locul unde va înălța puterea lui David, guvernul Israelului. Narațiunea începe, de fapt, cu Avraam, care s-a închinat împreună cu preoții din Salem. Mulți savanți sunt de părere că este vorba de Ierusalim. E într-adevăr un eveniment extraordinar.
Uimitor! Care e semnificația spirituală a evenimentului? Ce impact are?
Sunt de acord cu cele spuse de doctorul Becker. Evenimentele se leagă de Avram și de patriarhi. Însuși, Domnul Iisus a spus că Ierusalimul este capitala Marelui Împărat. Evenimentul e semnificativ pentru trupul lui Hristos. Chiar și din punct de vedere escatologic, am văzut înființarea națiunii. Anul viitor, țara va avea 70 de ani. Și în acest an, Ierusalimul se află de 50 de ani sub jurisdicție israeliană. Avem multe motive de bucurie și multe motive pentru a-i mulțumi președintelui Trump pentru curajul pe care l-a avut când a luat această decizie.
Este această decizie un răspuns la rugăciunea americanilor și a creștinilor din lumea întreagă?
Da. Îndemn telespectatorii să citească Isaia 62. Isaia 62 este chemarea pe care am primit-o mulți și am primit-o mulți de pe întreg globul. Isaia 62 spune: pe zidurile tale, Ierusalime, am pus niște străjeri care nu vor tăcea niciodată, nici zi, nici noapte. Voi care aduceți aminte Domnului de el, nu vă odihniți deloc și nu-i dați răgaz până nu va așeza din nou Ierusalimul și îl va face o laudă pe pământ. Cred că aceasta este doar o mică parte a chemării. Noi creștinii am simțit cu toții chemarea să ne rugăm pentru evrei, pentru Israel, pentru Ierusalim.
Psalmul 132 vorbește despre Sion ca locul unde Dumnezeu a spus: acesta este locul meu de odihnă pe vecie. Voi locui în el, căci l-am dorit. E un eveniment foarte important pentru creștini. Cred că cea mai importantă întrebare se referă la loialitatea lui Dumnezeu. A rămas Dumnezeu credincios promisiunii pe care a făcut-o poporului său și apoi Israelului? Dacă acele promisiuni nu se vor împlini, dacă Dumnezeu nu este credincios, nu ne mai rămâne nimic în ce să credem.
Așa e. Îmi place versetul citat de doctorul Becker, Psalmul 132, unde Domnul spune: acesta este locul meu de odihnă pe vecie. Dumnezeu iubește acel oraș unde Domnul și Mântuitorul nostru a fost răstignit și a înviat. Trebuie să ne bucurăm împreună cu poporul evreu și să ne rugăm pentru popoarele din zonă. Este un pas bun pe care l-a făcut președintele nostru și o binecuvântare pentru poporul evreu.
Știm că această decizie nu are doar urmări spirituale, ci consecințe în viața de zi cu zi. Palestinienii au promis 3 zile de răzbunare împotriva acestei decizii. Lumea arabă este împotriva acestei decizii. De unde vine respingerea?
This pushback, I think, comes from two very important aspects. Firstly, there is the religious claim. And of course, this claim.
Această respingere are două motivații. În primul rând, există o revendicare religioasă. Această revendicare, această tradiție nu apare în Coran, conform căreia Mahomed ar fi mers în Israel să se roage în moschee, care s-ar putea să se fi construit imediat după moartea sa sau după acea perioadă. De asemenea, statul palestinian sau teritoriile palestiniene revendică Ierusalimul drept capitala lor. Din punct de vedere istoric, această teorie nu are niciun temei, nu poate fi apărată. Psalmul 123 vorbește despre Ierusalim și spune: acolo voi înălța puterea lui David. Conform Scripturii, acesta este locul de unde va fi guvernat Israelul.
Cu privire la respingerea care vine din partea Organizației pentru Eliberarea Palestinei, trebuie să ne gândim la Psalmul 122. Ne putem ruga pentru palestinieni, pentru evrei, pentru toți cei care respectă Ierusalimul. Aș dori să citesc din Psalmul 122. Rugați-vă pentru pacea Ierusalimului, cei ce te iubesc să se bucure de odihnă, pacea să fie între zidurile tale și liniștea în casele tale domnești. Din pricina fraților și a prietenilor mei, doresc pacea în sânul tău. Din pricina casei Domnului, Dumnezeului nostru, fac urări pentru fericirea ta. Indiferent ce se va întâmpla, noi ne putem ruga pentru pace între palestinieni și evrei. Să-i cerem Domnului să potolească cu ploaie din ceruri orice foc aprins de om.
Amin.
A fost o știre despre semnificația spirituală a declarării Ierusalimului ca și capitală a Israelului, un comentariu competent realizat în studioul Sibian din Statele Unite ale Americii, un comentariu, cred eu, provocator și pentru noi. Așadar, așa pentru o clipă în alta să intrăm în legătură cu Jürgen Bühler din Ierusalim. Am pregătit câteva întrebări pentru dânsul, întrebări care cred că sunt în consens cu lucrurile care sunt și în inima dumneavoastră. Pentru cei însă care sunt mai puțin familiarizați cu Jürgen Bühler și cu International Christian Embassy, vă reamintesc că noi difuzăm pe Alpha Omega TV în fiecare săptămână emisiunea Word from Jerusalem, Cuvânt din Ierusalim, realizat în această organizație. Îl vedeți pe Jürgen aproape în fiecare săptămână pe canalul Alpha Omega TV. Pentru dumneavoastră însă, ca o introducere, un scurt spot, un scurt material în care este prezentată viziunea și scopurile și menirea acestei organizații acolo în Israel.
For this new year 2018, I want to greet you here from the city of Jerusalem. This past year 2017 has been an amazing year, a year of anniversaries. We saw 50 years since the city of Jerusalem was being reunited. We saw 100 years since the Balfour Declaration, 100 years since Lord Allenby was liberating this city. And this year is going to celebrate 70 years of the State of Israel. I believe if you look at those numbers in a biblical context, they speak of a season of completion, that a period has been ended and something new is starting. And I do believe that the year 2018 will be an amazing year for the State of Israel, where God will launch a whole new season of fulfillment for the Jewish people. But I believe also it's going to be a season of fulfillment and blessing for your own personal life. I want to encourage you to trust God for a breakthrough in 2018. I want to encourage you to dare to dream with God for your own life, for your family, and even for your community. This is going to be a year, a season of blessing. And I want to encourage you right here from the city of Jerusalem to turn this year 2018 into your own personal season of blessing for you and also for your family. So the Lord bless you greatly right here out of Jerusalem.
Country in all of human history. and the single most influential place that's impacted your life. It was the home of the prophets, the location that once held the Holy of Holies, and the birthplace of the Gospels. The connection between this land and your heart is undeniable, but you can also be a blessing to this nation by partnering with the International Christian Embassy Jerusalem. Now is an exciting time to be a part of what God is doing in Israel. Biblical prophecy is being fulfilled before our eyes. The Jewish people are returning to their homeland from the four corners of the earth, and life has returned to the land itself. And the Holy Spirit has been moving on the heart of Christians, just like you, to be a part, and ICEJ has been there. For more than 35 years, ICEJ has been the direct connection to the land of Israel for Christians all around the world. And together, we are helping the needy, providing shelter for Holocaust survivors, integrating new immigrants, supporting minorities, mentoring youth at risk, and have actively helped 120,000 Jews come home to Israel. These are just a few of the people groups ICEJ is impacting. And with a reach of over 170 nations, the International Christian Embassy Jerusalem has become a leading voice of Christian support and friendship to the Jewish people. So get involved and be a blessing to the nation and the people of Israel. The International Christian Embassy Jerusalem, your embassy, your voice. Join us today.
A fost câteva imagini despre întâlnirea Christian Embassy for Jerusalem. Vă spuneam, am reușit să ne conectăm cu Jürgen Bühler. El este în studioul lui din Ierusalim. Îi spunem bine ai venit. Colegii noștri au realizat această conexiune pe care sperăm să o avem în bune condiții până la sfârșitul emisiunii. As I promised to you, we have now on direct connection with Alpha Omega Studio Jürgen Bühler. We mentioned a few things about him and his ministry, International Christian Embassy for Jerusalem. Jürgen, thank you for being available for this interview directly from Jerusalem with us. I just say a few words about you, and we just saw a video promo about International Christian Embassy from Jerusalem in this program, Reality and Perspective. So, but first of all, give us few points about the ministry and the goal, the vision of the ministry for the people who are not exactly familiar with what we are doing in Jerusalem.
Well, Tudor, first of all, I want to thank you for having me on Alpha Omega TV. It's a great honor for us also to partner with you. And the Christian Embassy is a ministry that is in Jerusalem now since 1980. When all the embassies left Jerusalem, a group of Christians started an initiative to say, if all the embassies are abandoning Israel and Jerusalem, we want to make a sign of solidarity and friendship and support to the Jewish people. And this was the establishment of the ICEJ, or the International Christian Embassy Jerusalem. And what we do since then, we have a multiple segment of different outreaches here here to Israel. We are helping day in and day out Holocaust survivors. We have been involved with the return of more than 130,000 Jewish people coming back from the former Soviet Union, but also from places like Ethiopia, India, and many other places around the world. So we are a ministry of comfort who want to show the Jewish people a new face of Christianity and of Jesus. You know, you have to understand, I am from Germany, and a lot of people, when they think about Christianity, they think about the persecution throughout the century, and in particular of the Holocaust that just took place 70 years ago. So one of the core callings of our ministry is to be a voice of comfort and to show the Jewish people that there are Christians all over the world which love them, which support them, and which want to show them their unconditional love and friendship.
Okay, thank you, Jürgen. So some of our viewers, they know about you, about your ministry, because we are running every week a program that you are producing in Jerusalem for international distribution. We talk a little bit later about this. But the main event that we want to focus in the following minutes, it's about the Jerusalem, the city, the hot city at this point, and about the declaration in January from President Trump from United States that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel. Tell us a few things about this significant event, because people said this December declaration was something who challenged the old nations and was maybe one of the most challenging event in the world in 2017.
Well, I do believe it should have been the most exciting and joyful event in the world in the last year, because it was a decision that was long overdue. This decision of Donald Trump wasn't actually born in his mind, and it didn't come up with the idea suddenly to move the embassy to Jerusalem. But every single government from the time of George Bush and Bill Clinton, Barack Obama, this law was established already more than 20 years ago to move the American embassy to Jerusalem. Every president until then, they decided not to do it, and they were signing a waiver. And President Trump said, he says, this cannot be that we have a resolution, a law passed by the Congress and the Senate in a huge overwhelming majority. And he said, also, we promised this to the people that we are going to do it. He says, it's about time that finally the United States is fulfilling their more than 20-year-old promise to Israel. And I believe, you know, it's a very helpful act for the region. You know, you had some initial demonstrations, but we have to face it. The big obstacle for any peaceful solution with the Palestinians is the city of Jerusalem. And Trump was underlining, says, we make sure that Jerusalem is the Jewish capital. There's no discussion about it. So this matter will not be any more discussed in the future, but it is a fixed situation now where there's no discussion about it, and now they can move on things that are far easier to be solved.
So we as a Christian here in Romania, Orthodox Christian, Catholic Christian, or Evangelical, we know from the Bible that Jerusalem is a capital designated by God of Israel. But from political point of view, this is a challenge for many nations. So why it's important for a nation, as Romania and as many nations, to consider from political perspective to move the capital in Jerusalem, or to consider that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel? Why is it so important? For us, a Christian, it's clear, but why for political leaders and for nations?
Well, one of the reasons I just gave them, I do believe, unlike what you hear in the media today, that this is a decision that on a long term will support the peace process and actually accelerate it. But secondly, I do believe that Israel as a nation can become a major partner for a nation like Romania. You know, Israel is today one of the most innovative countries in the whole world. There is no nation in the world which have more patents and startup companies and inventions that are changing our daily life, from the high tech of cell phones and internet technology, even what we are doing right now, Skyping here from Jerusalem to Romania. Romania. It was an invention made in Tel Aviv at the Tel Aviv University. So I believe Israel is a nation that can give so much to every nation around the world. And to recognize its capital, you know, it's amazing to think about. The world is telling the Jewish people they cannot decide sovereignly what is their own capital. Nobody would dare to tell the Romanian people what is their capital, or Germany what is our capital. But the world tries to tell Israel what should be their capital and what not. And I believe to align with the U.S. government and to support this move, this would be an act of friendship with the only democracy in the Middle East. And then also, I do believe there is a spiritual component to it. You know, the Word of God tells us that he who blesses Israel will be blessed. And I do believe, absolutely convinced about it, that as your nation lines up with the Jewish people, that there is a God in heaven who will watch and he will bless the nation of Romania in a tremendous way.
In fact, Jürgen, this was my like a question for me, because now in this day that we're taping this interview and we're reading this interview, here in Romania we have a lot of challenges, political challenges, government challenges, and people said Jerusalem and Israel is one problem, we have our own problem internally. But you mentioned something about aligning our nation and other nations with God's plan, and something about God's desire to protect, to be involved in the life of a nation who is align with his plan for Israel. Maybe you can underline a few things. What means alignment of a nation? You mentioned this word alignment. What means for a nation like Romania to be aligned with Israel? Maybe you can underline once again, because this is very important for us as a Christian nation.
You know, the Bible actually gives quite a number of examples how nations either decided to curse the Jewish people or they made a political decision to stand alongside the Jewish people. And one of the great rulers in the Bible that is even prophesied that he would do it is King Cyrus of Persia. He was the ruler of a world empire, and he made a strategic decision to align themselves or align himself and his nation with Israel. And he became instrumental for the rebuilding of the Jewish state, for the rebuilding of the temple. And God, in a very unique way, visited him. And the same is true for many other nations in history. You know, when nations were establishing a covenant with Israel, we can see how God was blessing them. And I do believe the same principle is true for today. I was just recently in the United Kingdom, and I believe, Tudor, you have been with me there at the Royal Albert Hall when we commemorated the great acts that United Kingdom has accomplished over the past century to align themselves with the nation of Israel. It was not only the Balfour Declaration, but they were instrumental to help establish the state of Israel. And I do believe such things, they are indeed a strategic decision for every government to stand with Israel, because it will attract like a magnet the blessing of God towards a nation.
And then what will be your advice for us as a Christian media, what to do? Yes, of course, we can challenge our people in Romania to pray for this move, for the right decision of the Romanian government and presidential, but what to do more than this?
I do believe, you know, there are two major things. Number one, I want to encourage all the Romanian Christians to talk to their governments, to talk to their member of parliament, which they are living in his region, but also to send letters to the president, underlining the historic ties that every Christian nation has with the nation of Israel. And secondly, I would not diminish the power of prayer. If you look at the Bible, the past histories of the time of Daniel, of the time of Ezra in Nehemiah, prayer and the prophetic ministry that was available at the time was a central part to align nations with Israel. And I do believe also today that prayers are the most powerful tool that the church has. And I want to encourage the church to trust God for the impossible. Maybe there are some statements from politicians that we do not want to line up with Israel, but I would not take this as the final word. The last word in every nation is the word that God has in heaven. So I want to encourage the church to plead with God, to call forth even days of fasting and to seeking the Lord in order that your nation will line up with God's purposes in regard God to the nation of Israel, and I know that God is a prayer answering God.
Thank you, Jürgen, for this challenge, and I will, through Alpha Omega program, through this program, and not only, we continue to challenge the Romanian nation, Romanian Christians, to pray for this important decision that we as a nation we have to take, I think, and praying also for God's intervention in our situation, in our nation, because really we are a crossroad, and as a nation we really need God's intervention. And why not this decision about moving the embassy in Jerusalem could be a key moment for the whole history of our nation. Jürgen, I want to use this.
If I can add one more thing, yes? The word of God is very clear. In the book of Proverbs, it tells us that God is the one who is directing the hearts of kings like the rivers of water. The book of Daniel tells us in chapter 2 and also in chapter 5 that it is God who appoints kings and rulers of this world. So in a way, what the word of God is suggesting to us that indeed heaven reigns, and that the ultimate and the final authority rests with God in heaven. So I would again encourage the church in Romania to approach him who is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, because the final fate of your nation is not in the parliament or with the president of your nation, but it is resting with God. And it's upon the people of God in your nation to plead with God, to have mercy on your nation. And I know our God, he is a prayer answering God.
Yeah, thank you for this challenge and for this encouragement. And talking about the prayer, I know you are, as a ministry, and also as Jerusalem, and as Israel, we have a lot of challenges. So we want to use this chance to have from you from some prayer points for our viewers, from our Christian, from our prayer warriors, intercession. Please give us a few points, how to pray for Israel. Of course, the embassy issue is one aspect, but what other things are for us as a challenge to pray here in Romania for Israel and for you as a ministry?
You know, the entire region of the Middle East today is in a massive shakeup. What you see in the Middle East today unfolding is unforeseen. I believe nobody would have foretold you 6 or 7 years ago what we are seeing today. The first point what I want to highlight in that regard is, of course, the Syrian situation at the northern border. There is right now a military conflict carried out, and it looks like that the regime of Assad is being stabilized again. And I believe this is something that we need to pray for, because the church in Syria, number one, they have been persecuted over the last couple of years, in particular by a radical Islamist group. And groups, in particular ISIS, who was attacking the churches. But also, I believe this whole nation needs to, exactly what we said about Romania, we need to pray that God is aligning that nation with Israel. There's a great prophecy in Isaiah chapter 19 that speaks, one day there will be a highway that will go from Egypt to Israel all the way to Assyria. And part of that Assyrian empire is indeed Syria today. So I believe there is a prophetic destiny for those nations to partner with Israel. And many people might say, well, this is not possible that this is happening, because we do see radical Islamic regimes in that area. And Syria today is a nation that is hostile to Israel. But if you look what is happening today with countries like Egypt, countries like Saudi Arabia, things are developing and unfolding today which are unprecedented in the history of that region. Israel today has probably a stronger relationship to Egypt than with many European countries. And as a matter of fact, in the whole fight against Islamic terrorism, both Saudi Arabia and Egypt are looking towards Israel for help. So we see a very unusual alignment with those countries, with Israel, that they realize the only solution for us to overcome radical Islam in the region is to look for Israel to help them. And let us pray and trust God that something similar can happen also with the nation of Syria and also with the nation of Iraq. Another nation that needs our prayer is the country of Iran. We do see over the last few weeks and days that there is unrest unfolding. We had some very severe prayer meetings here in Jerusalem, and we did feel that the Spirit of God was telling us that there is a season of change coming for the nation of Iran, that this ungodly regime, this dark regime of radical Islam, that God is going to unseat this regime, and that a new government will come in place that will allow freedom, in particular for the church. And I think this is something which we have to pray. This is not only in the interest of the Iranian people that finally they enter into a season of freedom, but this is also very important for Israel as the number one enemy in the region that constantly calls for the destruction of Israel is the nation of Iran. So I call upon all the intercessors in Romania to use this time right now to call for and pray forth a change in the nation of Iran. Next year, we will have 40 years of an Iranian regime as they entered Iran in 1979. And I was reminded of a very similar situation when the East Germany was being reunited and the Berlin Wall was falling in 1989. This was exactly 40 years after the German Democratic Republic, the communist side of Germany, was being established. And after 40 years, God says, now we will reunify, there's a change coming. And I pray and I trust God that the same will happen to Iran.
Thank you, Jürgen, for this short overview of the Middle East situation and main prayer challenge. For sure, in the following months, we come again and again to see what's new, what are new prayer points, prayer challenges. But I don't want to use this chance to also ask from you a few things about International Christian Embassy from Jerusalem, about your ministry. You are organizing many events. You have many projects. One of the events that is known all over the world, including in Romania, it's this Feast of Tabernacle, the coming one, 2018 edition. Please give us few information about this and, of course, a challenge for the Romanian Christian who wants to be part of this event.
I do believe, thank you, Tudor, for asking that. I do believe this upcoming feast in 2018, in October, or it's the end of September this year in 2018, it is going to be a once-in-a-lifetime Feast of Tabernacles. As we are celebrating 70 years of the State of Israel, 70 years of independence of Israel, this is going to be a historic feast where we expect very great speakers from around the world. We have already Daniel Kolenda confirmed and many other great men of God from every continent of the world. But also we expect some senior leaders from the Israeli government to join us. But most importantly, this is going to be an unprecedented season where we are going all people together from around the world to worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords in the city of the great King. You know, the Feast of Tabernacles, it's a historic feast that the Bible even was telling us before. I believe it's, as a matter of fact, the only conference the Bible speaks about it already centuries ago. In Zechariah chapter 14, the prophet says the day will come when the nations of the world will come to Jerusalem and they're going to worship the God of Israel during the season of the Feast of Tabernacles. So I do want to invite the Romanian people. We have every year a big march in Jerusalem where people walk through the streets of Jerusalem. And wouldn't be this an amazing blessing if next year there would be a huge delegation from Romania walking through the streets of Jerusalem, declaring to the nation of Israel and the city of Jerusalem, we love you, we stand at your side, and we love the Jewish people.
Yes, I ask our people from editing to include here a few moments from a last edition of March from Jerusalem because we were there, we taped there, and our desire, our deep desire was to see a large Romanian delegation who will be part in the following years to this huge event. Talking about our partnership with Alpha Omega, for a few years already, we are airing here in Romania a program that we are producing in your studio in your location in Jerusalem. We call it Word from Jerusalem. We air this program every week, every Shabbat, plus rerun. Tell us a few things about the idea to produce this program and about your expectation for this program.
Well, Tudor, if you allow me to say something before, and I know you did not ask me to say that, but we are so blessed to partner with Alpha Omega TV. This is indeed a gift from heaven. And I know so many people in the Balkan area which are blessed by your program. And even those people who are watching us today, I want to encourage you to support this amazing station that is not only bringing programs from Israel, but I know they are a central part of what God is doing in the Balkan area today, and in particular, of course, Romania. So for us, it's a privilege to work with you. And regarding our program, The World of Jerusalem, our vision for that program is, I know there are people around the world which never will be able to visit Israel. So in a way, we want to allow them to have Israel or the Israel experience in their living room, that as they switch on their television, that they can see the landscape where Jesus was walking. And not only that, but we are taking our Bible, we are opening the Bible and the Word of God at the places that where the biblical background story and the geographical locations where the Bible was written, we're taking people there, we open the Word of God in those locations, and we are teaching the Word of God out of that very country where the Word of God was written. I think this is a one in a lifetime and a very unique approach to the Word of God. And of course, we want to invite all the viewers in Romania to watch it.
Yeah, thank you for this. And I'm praying that God will give you ideas, resources to produce more and more program and higher quality. And this program is a real blessing for us and for our viewers through you and through Alpha Omega TV. So many Christians from Romania, they want to pray for you, they want to pray for Israel, they want to support Israel. Even some of them, they call us, they say, I want to put a seed in Israel, in a ministry from Israel. And from time to time, as you know, we collect some of the seeds, financial seed, and we put something from our side and we send to you. Please let us know how to pray for you as Christian in Romania, and how, if someone has in their heart to bless you financially directly, what to do and what's the best. Of course, we put on the screen now your site to find more information, but tell us in your words about this.
Well, I do believe the most important support that we can receive from any country in the world is prayer. We do know we are a ministry of prayer. We actually have prayer groups in more than 120 nations around the world, people who do constantly pray for us. And I know out of personal experience the power and the importance of prayer. I know, Tudor, you know it very well. I was sick 2 years ago, and the doctors here in Israel have given up on me. They said, this is inoperable, we cannot help you anymore. But people all over the world were praying for me, and praise God, God completely restored my health. So we know there is incredible power with prayer, and I do ask the Romanian church and Christians in Romania, please pray for the International Christian Embassy. Pray for the resources, for all the finances that are needed to carry out our ministry. We are right now in the process of purchasing a property where we can have a more permanent office here in Jerusalem. And so please pray for those matters. Pray for our leadership. Even for me personally, we need your prayers. But also, if the Lord places on your heart to put a financial seed into our ministry, I want to encourage you to check out our website that you see right now at the lower third of the screen. Go to our website at www.icej.org, and there you will find a way how you can support the Christian Embassy, either by credit card, or you can find an address where you can post your check and make it as payable towards the International Christian Embassy Jerusalem. And I want to encourage you to consider supporting even this nation in a financial way, because again, here it is true, the Lord says, those who bless thee, they will be blessed. And I personally experienced that God is indeed a God who is blessing us in return.
Oh, thank you, Jürgen, for this information. I hope many Romanians will bless your ministry, Israel, and will bless financially in prayer and also visiting Israel. You invite us earlier to consider Feast of Tabernacle 2008, but there are many events every month in Israel, and more Romanian Christians are visiting Israel from different denominations. I mentioned to you in the recent discussion that we have three cities connected by airlines with Tel Aviv, Bucharest, Cluj, Timișoara. We have many Romanians that are taking planes from departure from Budapest, from Debrecen, and also with El Al and Tarom. So God opened many ways for Romanians to attend Israel. And one of the news recently in Romania was the 3 million viewers, even more visitors in Israel. The 3 million person was from Romania, and Mr. Netanyahu was the one who welcomed him. So I think it's a way to bless Israel if we visit Israel. This is a challenge for our viewers.
Absolutely. And, you know, let me encourage you with that. Just yesterday, I received a testimony from Albania. There was a pastor's couple in Albania who wanted to come to Jerusalem. The Lord actually appeared to her in a dream at night and said, you should go to the places where I was living. And she understood the Lord called her to come to Jerusalem. She shared it with her husband, and they both agreed, we don't have any finances to do that. We have no way how we could pay the flight tickets or the hotel costs for Israel. And then they said, well, if the Lord wants us to go there, why don't we trust the Lord for that? And they started to pray for that. The very next day, they received a phone call from a city, from a lady, completely unexpectedly. And she says, I feel the Lord spoke to me that we should send you some money in order to enable you to come to Jerusalem. And it was exactly, precisely the amount of money they needed in order to travel to Israel. So I want to encourage the listeners and viewers even today, that even if you say, well, I will never be able to afford coming to Israel, God is able to bring you to Israel. So trust the Lord even there for a miracle.
Yes, we believe that God is able to do more miracles this year. We pray this in Alpha Omega Ministry. We pray for our nation and, of course, for Israel, that this season will be a season when God will intervene with miracle and signs in the history and in our lives. Yuran, we talk a lot about prayer, so we don't want to finish this discussion without a word of prayer from you. Of course, any prayer and from Jerusalem is a special blessing, so we want to have a word of blessing for our ministry and from our nations, from Jerusalem, from you.
Yes, with pleasure I do that. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your presence, even right now as people are watching this television program. And Father, first of all, I would like to lift up the nation of Romania before your throne. I do ask you, Father, that you bless the government of Romania to make wise decision, in particular in regards to their alignment with the nation of Israel. Father, we call forth a new season, a fresh season of friendship between Romania and the nation of Israel. Father, bless the nation of Romania. Pour out your spirit over this nation. Send revival to Romania. And Father, in the name of Jesus, we also do ask you for Alpha Omega TV, that this year will be a season of blessing for Alpha and Omega TV, that you will do something new, that you open new doors, that you will pour out fresh resources into that ministry. And I do ask you also, every person who is watching us today, Father, they might need a touch from God regarding their health. They might need a financial breakthrough. They might need a spiritual breakthrough. Wherever they are right now, Father, bless them in the name of Jesus. Come with your healing power into their living room. Solve their family problems in the name of Jesus, where they need restoration in their marriage. Father, we call forth restoration and reconciliation. Father, bless the Jewish people in Romania and bless the church in Romania. We pray this in the powerful and mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Jürgen, thank you so much for this prayer and for all this information and prayer challenges for us here in Romania through this program. And we promise that we'll come again for new information, fresh details about the situation in Jerusalem, in Israel, and in the Middle East. May God bless you abundantly and continue to be a source of blessing for Israel and for all the nation. Acesta a fost Jürgen Bühler, președintele probabil cele mai mari organizații pro-Israel din întreaga lume, International Christian Embassy for Jerusalem. localizată și așezată chiar în inima Ierusalimului, organizație care, într-un fel, nu numai spiritual, ne reprezintă pe noi toți creștinii de întreaga lume, acolo în Israel. Rugați-vă, primiți îndemnurile care au fost acolo și luați decizii după cum Dumnezeu vă călăuzește. Am vrea să încheiem această emisiune cu secvențe de la un eveniment mai puțin mediatizat. A fost o vizită anul trecut în România a unei delegații din Parlamentul Israelian, din Knessetul Israelian. Am fost întâlniri la vârf cu membrii ai Parlamentului din România. Din fericire sau din păcate, nu știu cum să-i zic, n-au participat la acea întâlnire decât o mică echipă de la Alpha Omega. N-au participat alte organizații, alte televiziuni, alte instituții de media. A rămas un eveniment poate ascuns, dar iată că prin aceste imagini încercăm să vi-l aducem în atenție. A fost așadar o întâlnire în Parlamentul Românesc cu participarea unor lideri politici din România care au o inimă și o deschidere către Israel. Lideri politici, membri ai Parlamentului sau ai Guvernului, a fost și lideri spirituali care într-o întâlnire separată și-au arătat deschiderea către Israel. Cred că va fi o provocare, veți înțelege poate altfel cum deja Dumnezeu a pregătit inimi la nivelul leadershipului politic și religios din România pentru o aliniere a României în aceste vremuri foarte complicate cu Israel. Așadar, secvențe de la o întâlnire a unei delegații la vârf israelian în România, întâlniri cu lideri spirituali și politici din România.
Mă numesc Ioan Deneș, fac parte din grupul parlamentar social-democrat al Partidului Social-Democrat. În al doilea mandat sunt creștin practicant, provin din regiunea istorică numită Transilvania, dintr-un oraș unde în urmă cu 50 de ani era un oraș unde exista o comunitate importantă evreiască și această comunitate, ca de altfel și în zona din jurul acestui oraș, această comunitate și-a pus o amprentă puternică pe societatea și comunitățile din acele zone, aducându-și aminte cu plăcere oamenii despre modul în care se conviețuia în acele vremuri românii cu maghiarii, cu evreii, care toți împreună făceau un întreg al acelei comunități.
Haver Knesset Yaakov Margi, Yoshev Rosh Vadat HaChinuch, HaTarbut VaSport shel HaKnesset.
I am the member of parliament named Yaakov Margi. I am the chairman of the Education, Culture and Sports Committee of the Parliament of Israel, the Knesset.
ושר הדתות לשעבר.
And I am the former Minister of Religious Affairs for the State of Israel.
כחבר הקונגרס היהודי העולמי, היה חשוב לי להגיע לפה גם בתפקידי כחבר כנסת.
It was very important to me as a board member of the World Jewish Congress and as a member of Knesset to come here today.
להגיע לכאן לרומניה, לפרלמנט הרומני,
come to Romania, to the Parliament of Romania.
לכונן כאן שדולה, אגודת ידידות, פרלמנטרית, שמבוססת על חברי הפרלמנט הנוצרים ברומניה.
It's important to now establish our 36th Israel Allies Caucus, a parliamentary group that is based on Christian representatives in the Romanian parliament.
מדינת ישראל מתמודדת בגאון, אני אומר, בכבוד, עם סוגיית חופש הדת לכל הדתות.
In Israel, and we're very proud of this, we stand for religious freedoms and all of religions. We give freedom to all religions in Israel.
גם רומניה, גם ישראל נמצאים באזור לא הכי פשוט ולא הכי רגוע.
Both the state of Israel and the country Romania are located in some dicey neighborhoods, let's say, not always a friendly neighborhood.
וסליחה שאני אהיה דרמטי, אני חושב שבימים אלה העולם הנאור, גם היהודים, גם הנוצרים, גם חלק מהעולם המוסלמי, מאוימים, מונפת חרב חדה על צווארו של העולם הנאור.
And I don't want to be overdramatic, but I feel that in today's world, especially the Jews and the Christians, and even some of the moderate Muslims, are under threat by radical Islam. They have the swords at their neck.
אני חושב שיש תפקיד חשוב לקהילות הנוצריות בעולם, וכאן ברומניה, יחד איתנו, חברי הפרלמנט בכנסת בישראל, תפקיד חשוב לשתף פעולה, לאחד כוחות, לשלב ידיים, כדי להביא מסר של רוגע, מסר של אמונה, מסר שמה שהתנ"ך נותן לנו, אמונה חזקה שלאדם האדם יש לו מקום, הוא מרכזו של העולם, האדם מרכזו של העולם.
I think that it's essential that Bible-believing Christians around the world, and especially here in Romania today, link arms with Israel and comes with a very clear statement of faith that our Judeo-Christian civilizations are the most important to defend, and that life and the sanctity of people is one of the most important tenets of that faith, and that we need to unite to defend our shared values.
היום קוננו את השדולה 35 באירופה, כאן ברומניה, זו השדולה מספר 35 של שיתופי פעולה פרלמנטרי. אני חושב שחברי הפרלמנט שנפגשנו איתם היום, וגם שר הביטחון שפגשנו אותו אתמול, מכירים בערך של שיתוף הפעולה בין הנוצרים לפרלמנט הישראלי. אני חושב שזה רק התחלה של שיתוף פעולה.
We came here today to launch our 36th Israel Allies Caucus in governments around the world. I believe that today at this meeting was very impressive to see the members of Parliament Romania, and of course also yesterday at lunch with the Minister of Defense. We saw that they see the need for this type of cooperation based on faith between the government of Romania and the Parliament of Israel.
רק בדרכים כאלה אנחנו יכולים להביא בשורה לעולם, בשורה של אהבה, בשורה של שלום, בשורה של שגשוג.
Only through faith-based diplomacy do I believe we can bring strength to the world, peace, love, and things that are important in conflict that only Judeo-Christian values can bring.
ובאמצעותכם, תודה רבה לעם הרומני ולממשלת רומניה ולחברי הפרלמנט ברומניה.
And I want to thank you for this opportunity to speak to the nation of Romania, so I can say to them directly, thank you. Thank you for your support and thank you for what you're doing for Israel.
Relația dintre România și Israel este o relație specială. În termeni politici, aș spune că e o relație strategică și așa și este, care are o explicație istorică, explicație politică și înainte de 1989, o relație în care comunitatea evrească din România, dar și evrei originari din România care trăiesc în Israel, reprezintă o puntă de legătură extraordinară. La toate acestea se adaugă fundamentul creștin al României, vista acestei delegații israeliene, care a inclus atât reprezentanța ai Parlamentului, oameni cu demnități importante în statul Israel, dar și reprezentanți importanți din Congresul Mondial Evresc, care e o organizație foarte influentă, și alte organizații, reprezintă un semnal foarte important de strângere a legăturilor, și inclusiv ținând cont de faptul cum definesc ei, că statul Israel are nevoie de sprijinul statelor aliate creștine. Și România, da, este un stat care are un parteneriat strategic cu Israel și este o țară creștină. Așa că este o vizită importantă, o discuție foarte bună cu colegii deputați, senatori care fac parte din grupul ecumenic de rugăciune al Parlamentului României, care a subliniat încă o dată cât de profunde sunt relațiile dintre România și Israel.
Au fost câteva secvențe înregistrate de noi în anul care s-a încheiat la o vizită oficială a unei delegații a Knessetului israelian, a unor membri din Parlamentul israelian, al celui, cum îi zic, Caucus Alliance, a unei entități care caută alianțe în guvernele țărilor lumii pentru o poziționare corectă cu Israelul. Ne rugăm ca aceste imagini, dar nu numai, ceea ce face Domnul în această vreme în România, la nivelul liderilor politici și spirituali, să ducă la o aliniere tot mai clară și mai puternică și mai radicală și mai pe față a României cu Israelul. Și, desigur, de la un capăt la altul am discutat despre Ierusalim, capitala Israelului. Noi creștinii știm acest lucru, cunoaștem acest lucru. Știm din Biblie că Ierusalim a fost desenat de Dumnezeu să fie acolo capitală, dar iată că Dumnezeu ne provoacă la mai mult în acest an și rugăciunea noastră, ca o concluzie acestei emisiuni, ca la momentul potrivit România și multe alte națiuni să decidă, ca și din punct de vedere politic, o semnificație deosebită are și acest gen de decizii și din punct de vedere politic, capitala Israelului să fie așezată în Ierusalim. Cu această încredințare și cu această provocare vă las și vă aștept la emisiunea viitoare, Realități și Perspective. Dumnezeu să vă binecuvânteze!